Is there any chances of recurrence after surgery? Yes, there are. If you gain lot of weight, more than 10% of your body weight, what happens is sometimes even the fat accumulate, after some time estrogen levels will go high, automatically again breast tissue develops. So maintaining your weight is very mandatory in this kind of a surgery. Till you get the recurrence, it's better to check your hormone level. Sometimes your abnormal hormones might play a role in this. Sometimes if you take anabolic steroids and when a bodybuilding, lot of protein supplements, so like everything have a mild steroid in it. So though that off label, the label doesn't contain those things, a lot of patients I've seen only they take a protein supplement, they come up with a recurrence. So anabolic steroid, protein supplements has to be avoided to avoid the recurrence as much as possible. And other thing is, if your age advances above 50-60, when you're getting a testicular tumors, your testicular tumors also sometimes hormone producing tumors, those kind of a tumors also will produce a gynecomastia, late onset gynecomastia, always has to be evaluated by ultrasound of the scrotum to find out any cancers in the testis. You have to understand these things. These are all the three, four reasons you need to understand why you are getting the recurrence. After surgery, I feel hard tissues underneath. Is it normal? It might be below the areola, sometimes side of the chest, sometimes we do the side of the chest fat removal also. So is it normal? So during the healing phase, initially the swelling will be the soft swelling. That soft swelling become hard swelling after 10 days to 15 days. When the hard swelling there, you feel like a hard nodule kind of thing everywhere. Okay, so we can do a massage. Even nice hard massages will slowly make it disappear. And pressure garment and the hard massage will help. When you press that area, if you feel the pain, that is because of the swelling. If the swelling completely goes, you won't feel any pain. Then you need to ask the doctor whether sir, no pain is there, why still the bulge? You can ask the doctor. Okay, so when there is a pain, this still swelling is there, these kind of a hard nodules are very normal. Massage will help to reduce the hard nodule. If the hard tissues underneath is not going down after month, you have to ask the doctor. The doctor might prescribe a small injection in the over the hard tissue itself so that it will comes down. There is a lot of injections are available to make it disappear. You have to understand these things. Sometimes extremely rare cases, even the scar tissue, how it formed outside, even inside you can see some kind of a scar tissue. Okay, if it's not going down by any means, after 6 months you might consider a surgery if it is very much visible. Milder things, better not to go for a surgery again. One-sided gynecomastia, how to correct it? See, lot of people, they come with only one side issue, but usually if you examine the other side also, there will be a size difference. Might be grade 1 in one side and grade 3 in other side. So they say only they want to correct the one side. Actually ideal will be to correct both the sides together, because after correcting the grade 3, it looks like it's really flat and grade 1 looks bigger. So better to correct both the sides together, so then only results will be good. But extremely rare cases, one side will be extremely flat, other side will be completely bigger. So these cases, surgery will be extremely difficult because this will be purely glandular. It takes almost equal time of the normal gynecomastia surgery, both the sides together. Normally I take 1 hour to 1.5 hours. So even this doing a one side gynecomastia takes easily 1 hour. I already underwent a gynecomastia surgery few months back, so I'm not happy about the results. When I can go for the surgery again? This is a very common inquiry we get from the people who operated by other surgeons. What you have to understand is each surgeon have done their best to give you a good results. If you're not happy, first thing is to approach the surgeon and try to make your surgeon understand your concern. Sometimes even they are not understanding your concern, yes, you can opt to go for other doctors. But you have to wait at least 6 months before planning for the second surgery. So understand that 6 months you need to wait. Is there any difference in the sensation of the chest after surgery? I underwent surgery but I don't have a sensation. This kind of a complaint commonly we see in our practice. So usually before surgery, the sensation what you are feeling is mostly the glandular sensation. You feel like a little erotic and some different sensation you feel. After surgery, you might not be, you definitely won't have that kind of a sensation. There will be a touch and temperature sensation will come back. That too takes 2 to 3 months. Okay, once the nerve grows from down and gives a sensation to the nipple area, right? You feel little asensate during those areas. But after 3-4 months, usually you get back the sensation. But the sensation might not be the same what you had before surgery. You gotta understand that. The sensation is completely different. Sometimes it will be little lesser than the other side of the normal skin. But you will get it. You gotta understand. Doctor, you prefer the prescribe the skin tightening medications. Is it necessary for me? See, if you are in grade 1 and grade 2, maybe a 10 days or 15 days is okay. Even if you are not taking, that's adequate, okay only. Because I have seen people, when they take the skin tightening medications, which has a lot of collagen peptide in it, results are much better than people who are not taking. And grade 3 and grade 4, it's definitely mandatory. Even I prefer 10 days prior if they take the skin tightening medication, and after surgery also they follow it for another 40-45 days, results are much better in grade 3 and grade 4. Okay, that is mandatory in them. Grade 1, grade 2, it's very optional. Better to take the skin tightening medication according to your grade. What are the post-surgical medication I need to take? So usually we prescribe 5 days antibiotic and painkillers, and the stomach protectives, ulcer protectives, and along with that, as I explained earlier, the skin tightening medication like collagen peptide and sometimes that vitamin C, these things we ask them to take it for a month or 2 months. So these are all only medications you are going to take after surgery. Yes, if you have a diabetes or hypertension or thyroid problem, you have to continue taking other medications also. Sir, I have only a very small gland. Is liposuction necessary? See, I personally feel liposuction is necessary for all the cases, because when you're not making the surrounding skin thinner, if you remove completely the gland, definitely it looks like a little deformed one. So I advise all my patients undergo liposuction and gland excision together to get a good results. A lot of people argue, sir, I only have a gland, why can't you do only gland excision? I can do it, but when we say with our experience, it is better. Because of the surgery, any chances of getting an injury to my lungs and hearts, because it's very close by. It's a very common question usually parents ask. Okay, these questions easily you can understand. The surgery is between the skin and the muscle. If you want to approach the lungs and the heart, it's not so easy. Even when you're doing a thoracotomy and all, we need to spend half an hour to 45 minutes, break the rib and going inside. It's not so simple as you think. But all over the liposuction cannulas, their worry is liposuction cannula, when you're doing a liposuction, you feel that it bluntly we are going in and coming out. The cannulas are very, very blunt. Even if you want to pierce the muscle, it's very difficult. So going deeper, it's extremely difficult because it's a blunt cannula. More than that, we are so much careful in doing the surgery. So even in the literature, this kind of injuries are extremely rare. So don't worry, injuring the lungs and heart is not at all a complication of the surgery in a trained hands. What is crater deformity? See, usually what happens is when we are not doing a liposuction all around, only we remove the gland completely, what happens? That area becomes like a dent. So other areas looks normal, that area will go inside like a crater. So how to correct it? Usually most of the time, if you do a liposuction all around nicely, the crater, the intensity will come down. Sometimes we fill the fat, we take the fat from other areas and fill that crater deformity area, it will come up. So sometimes the crater deformity won't allow the fat to go inside. So we have to release it manually, making a small cut in that area, then put the fat, it will be spread all over. So it will be spread all over the crater deformity. This is how you need to correct it. Most of the time it needs a mild anesthesia to do it, and it's half an hour surgery. And if it's really looking odd, you need to think about it. Very milder, it's very negligible, don't go for a surgery again.